Here's what I did. I used the isUpper method of the word, which is a string, so string.isUpper method, to check if it is in fact an uppercase word. If it is, then I enumerate all the letters in the word. I reverse it. So this slice says reverse it. The missing numbers on either side of the colon says take the whole word, and the minus one says go from the back forward. So reverse the word, enumerate it, give me pairs of indexes from 0 to n along with the individual digits. And then I'm going to just say 10 to the ith power and the digit. And that gives us 1 times u plus 10 times o plus 100 times y. And it works out backwards from the normal YOU order, but that doesn't matter. I take those results, I put a plus sign in between them, and I wrap parentheses around them. And if it's not upper, I just return the word itself. Now explained the whole program. I'm calling it FasterSolve, and I take a formula. The first thing I do is compile the formula. That gives me back the function that represents it. And I'm also, while I'm there, I'm also returning the letters that are within the formula. That evaluation or compilation of the formula is done once. Then I go through all the permutations of the digits, taken length of letters at a time. And notice that I'm using actual integers here, not strings for the individual digits. If applying the function to the digits is true, then I did the same thing that I did before of making up a translation table and calling the formula.translate to get my final result. But note I only have to do this translation once on the specific permutation that I know works. I don't have to do it every time like I did in the previous version of Solve. And then if there's an arithmetic error, I catch that and go on to the next permutation. Now the function compile formula takes a formula as input. First I figure out all the letters, so that's going to be the Y, M, E, U, and O. Then I figure out that the list of parameters I want to put into my function is going to be a string consisting of the letters with a comma in between them. I figure out all the tokens. So a token is an individual term like the U or the equal signs or the me and so on.